Hi everyone, good morning all of you. This is Chanti from InfoBuddy and welcome to the current affairs session of 13th August 2020. Guys, this session contains 10 questions. For each question, you have 5 seconds to answer. So write down your answers in the comment box. And if you like the video, please like. If you are finding this is useful to others, then share it to others. And if you are new to this channel, please do subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell icon for latest notifications. The topics that are going to be covered in this session are World Biofuel Day, One District One Product, Ervaikulam National Park, E-Sanjeevani, Submarine Optical Fiber Cable, Indira One Methane Yojana, Nth Awards, Walter Roger Matos Ruse, 70th Anniversary Grand Prix 2020, and Sunsports. Coming to the first question of the day, the World Biofuel Day observed annually on Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas celebrates the World Biofuel Day on 10th August every year. So option D is the correct answer. On the occasion, the ministry also organized the webinar with the theme Biofuels Towards Atmanirbhar Bharat. The World Biofuel Day is observed every year to aware about the importance of non-fossil fuels as an alternative to conventional fossil fuels. The day also highlights the various actions taken by the government in the biofuel sectors. The current Union Minister for Petroleum and Natural Gas is Dharmendra Pradhan. So, the World Biofuel Day observed annually on 10th August. Option D. Next question. Flipkart signed MOU with which state government's One District One Product ODOP scheme recently? Indian homegrown e-marketplace Flipkart has signed an MOU with One District One Product scheme of the government of Uttar Pradesh. The MOU will bring the artisans, weavers and craftsmen under the ODOP scheme into the scope of the Flipkart Samad initiative. This will provide artisans, weavers and craftsmen under the ODOP scheme a momentum to expand their business online as they face social and economic challenges. The Flipkart Samad initiative will offer various services to artisans, weavers and craftsmen such as training, dedicated space in Flipkart's fulfillment centers, constant seller support along with cataloging, guidance and visibility on the platform. With the help of this, these underserved communities from Uttar Pradesh will get a push to showcase their specialized products and crafts to millions of customers across the country. The current Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Yogi Adityanath, and the Governor is Anandiben Patel. Next question. Ervaikulam National Park is located in Kerala. It was declared a sanctuary in 1975 with the intention of protecting the indigenous population of Nilgiri Thar and declared as a national park in 1978. This is also the land of Nelakurinji, a flower that blossoms once in 12 years. Anamudi, South India's highest peak, is situated in this park. Three major types of plant communities found in the park are grasslands, shrubland, and shola forests. Next question. Consider the following statements about E-Sanjeevani. Statement 1. The E-Sanjeevani platform has enabled two types of telemedicine services, doctor to doctor and patient to doctor teleconsultations. Statement 2. Both the platforms have been developed by the Center for Development of Advanced Computing, Mohali. Which of the above statements are the telemedicine service platforms of the Ministry of Health and Welfare, that is E-Sanjeevani and E-Sanjeevani OPD, have completed 1.5 lakh teleconsultations. The top two states which have registered the highest consultations through the platforms are Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. So, what is this E-Sanjeevani and E-Sanjeevani OPD? E-Sanjeevani is a doctor-to-doctor telemedicine system being implemented under Ayushman Bharat Health and Wellness Center, ABHWC program. Coming to this E-Sanjeevani OPD, it was launched amid the COVID-19 pandemic to enable patient-to-doctor teleconsultations. Offered at no cost, this e-health services had made it convenient for the people to avail for the health services without having to travel. It enables two-way interaction and even generates a prescription slip. It is hosting over 40 online outpatient department services More than half of these are specially outpatient departments, which include gynecology, psychiatry, antiretroviral therapy for the AIDS or HIV patients, non-communicable disease, etc. So these both platforms have been developed by Center for Development of Advanced Computing, CDAC Mohali. CDAC is the premier R&D organization of the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology for carrying out R&D in IT, electronics and associated areas. So coming to this, statement 1 is true and statement 2 is also true. So both 1 and 2 are correct. Option C is the right answer. Next question. Prime Minister of India has launched the first ever submarine optical fiber cable OFC connectivity between which of the following? On August 10th, Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated and dedicated to the nation submarine optical fiber OFC connecting Chennai, Tamil Nadu and Port Blair, Andaman Nicobar Islands through video conferencing. So from Chennai to Andaman Nicobar, option B, Chennai and Andaman Nicobar Islands. The connectivity will enable delivery of faster mobile and landline telecom services to Andaman Nicobar Islands at par with other parts of the India. The submarine OFC cable has been laid at a cost about 1224 crore rupees. The foundation stone for 2312 kilometer, so the distance is 2312, was laid by PM Narendra Modi on 30th November 2018 at Port Blair. The submarine cable will also connect Port Blair to Swaraj Deep, Little Andaman, Kar Nicobar and Great Nicobar, Long Island and Rangar. So this is the connectivity map. The submarine OFC link will deliver bandwidth of 2x200 gigabytes per second between Chennai and Port Blair and 2x100 gigabytes per second between Port Blair and the other islands. 4G mobile services, which were constrained due to limited backhaul bandwidth provided via satellite. So Airtel becomes first telecom to launch ultra-fast 4G services in Andaman and Nicobar. So option B is the correct answer. Next question. Which state launched Indira Van Mithan Yojana on the occasion of World Tribal Day? On 9th August 2020, in an event of International Day of World Indigenous Peoples or World Tribal Day, Chief Minister of Chhattisgarh, Bhupesh Baghel, announced the launch of Indira Van Mithan Yojana, an initiative to support the forest dwellers of Chhattisgarh to achieve self-reliance. So, Chhattisgarh. Option B is the right answer. This scheme aims to add around 19 lakh families from the scheduled areas of Chhattisgarh and provide self-employment opportunities to the tribal forest dwellers. So coming to this Chhattisgarh, the current chief minister is Bhupesh Baghel and governor is Anusuya Uke. The capital of Chhattisgarh is Raipur. Next question. Which of the following has launched the loyalty platform Nth Awards? NPCI, National Payment Corporations of India, launched a loyalty platform named Nth Awards. Here, Nth means infinite possibilities. It is an analytics-enabled omni-channel multi-branded loyalty platform. It allows users to earn infinite loyalty points, that means Nth loyalty points, through various bank transactions. These rewards points can be redeemed for various purposes including online shopping. Customer will earn loyalty points on almost every transaction made digitally, especially while using the credit or debit cards. Nth Rewards platform has a smart dashboard for users where they can see their points accumulation. So option B is the correct answer. National Payment Corporation of India, NPCI, launched loyalty platform Nth Rewards. Nth Rewards means infinite possibilities. Next question. Walter Roger Matos Ruse sworn in as the new Prime Minister of which country? The former Defence Minister and retired Army General Walter Roger Matos Ruse became the new Prime Minister of Peru. Option B is the correct answer. The President of Peru, Martin Vizcarra, confirmed his appointment. Lima is the capital of Peru. Lima is the capital of Peru and Peru currency is Peruvian sol. Next question. Who has won Emirates Formula One 70th Anniversary Grand Prix 2020? Max Verstappen, a Red Bull Northlands, has been won the 70th Anniversary Grand Prix held on 9th August 2020 in UK. Option D is the correct answer. This is the first win of the season for Verstappen. Lewis Hamilton, Mercedes Great Britain, came second while Valtteri Bottas came third. The 70th Anniversary Grand Prix Emirates Formula One 70th Anniversary Grand Prix 2020 was fifth race of 2020 Formula One World Championship held at the Silverstone Circuit in Silverstone, United Kingdom. So the 70th Anniversary Grand Prix held in United Kingdom. The race was held to commemorate 70 year of Formula One World Championship. The first championship Grand Prix was held at same circuit in 1950. Next question. Consider the following statements about sunspots. Statement 1. Sunspots are areas that appear dark on the surface of the sun. Second statement. The temperature of a sunspot is around 6500 degrees Fahrenheit. Which of the above statements are correct? Sunspots are the areas that appear dark on the surface of the sun, that is a photosphere. These sunspots are large as 50,000 kilometer in diameter. 50,000 kilometer in diameter. They appear dark because they are cooler than other parts of the sun's surface. However, the temperature of a sunspot is very hot, that means around 6500 degrees Fahrenheit. This photosphere is a visible surface of the sun from which is emitted most of the sun's light that reaches Earth directly. They are relatively cool because they form the areas where magnetic fields are particularly strong. These magnetic fields are so strong that they keep some of the heat within the sun from reaching the surface. Magnetic field in such areas is about 2500 times stronger than Earth's. They typically consist of a dark region called the umbra, which is surrounded by a lighter region called the penumbra. In every solar cycle, the number of sunspots increases and decreases. The current solar cycle, which began in 2008, is in its solar minimum phase, when the number of sunspots and solar flares is at a routine low. So, coming to this question, some of sunspots as large as 50,000 kilometers in diameter are areas that appear dark on the surface of the sun. So statement 1 is true. The temperature of a sunspot is around 6500 degrees Fahrenheit. So statement 2 is also true. So answer option C. Both 1 and 2 are correct. Once again, a quick revision of all these questions from 1 to 10. The World Biofuel Day observed annually on August 10th. Flipkart signed MOU with which state governments? One district, one product. ODOP scheme recently. Uttar Pradesh. Ervikulam National Park is located in Kerala. Consider the following statements about e-Sanjeevani. So, from this statement 1 and 2 are correct. Option C is the correct answer. Prime Minister of India has launched the first ever submarine optical fiber cable connectivity between Chennai to Andaman Nicobar Islands. Option B. Which state launched Indravan Mitra Yojana on the occasion of World Tribal Day? Chhattisgarh. Which of the following has launched the loyalty platform Nth Awards? NPCA, National Payments Corporation of India, launched this loyalty platform Nth Awards. Nth Award means infinite possibilities. Walter Roger Matos Ruz sworn in as the new Prime Minister of which country? Peru. The capital of Peru is Lima. Peruvian sol is the currency of Peru. Who has won the Emirates Formula One 70th Anniversary Grand Prix 2020? Max Verstappen. Consider the following statements about sunspots. Statement 1 and statement 2 are true. Both 1 and 2. C is the correct answer. Today's question is, what is AR2770? Write down your answer in the comment box. Yesterday's question. Which airport developed a Suvidha portal for international arriving passengers across India? Delhi International Airport. Delhi Airport as a contactless solution air suvidha for all passengers flying into the country that will enable them to submit the mandatory self-declaration form about their current health status and also apply online to seek exemption from mandatory institution or paid quarantine for allowed categories through this portal before 72 hours of flying to India. So friends, that's it from this session. I hope all of you enjoyed this session. Keep watching InfoBuddy and stay update yourself.
Thank you for watching. If you like the video, please like, comment and share, and don't forget to subscribe.